What's up, everybody in the Switch universe? A quick fun update for you this morning. We know that Rayman Legends Definitive Edition is hitting Nintendo Switch on September 12th for $39.99. And while it is a port, it'll be a great platformer to add to the Switch library as we wait for Super Mario Odyssey in October. Today, we find an eShop listing that reveals the file size of Rayman Legends Definitive Edition. And this may seem like a small nugget of info, but for a lot of people who like to go all digital and like to balance their games between a memory card and the onboard memory, it's important. So Rayman Legends Definitive Edition clocks in at 2.9 gigabytes, which is in line with a lot of the recent Nintendo Switch releases. And it's kind of surprising slash kind of impressive that they still are able to compact these games to such small sizes. Now, naysayers may say, oh gosh, this is terrible. The games are so much smaller than things on PS4 and on Xbox One, which is definitely a true and valid point, but I don't think that necessarily speaks to the quality or the fleshed out nature of these titles. I think Splatoon 2 is a great example that comes in at 3.1 gigabytes and is still a pretty darn fully featured and big game. If we compare that 2.9 for Rayman Legends to previous Switch games, it makes sense. You've got ARMS at 2.2, Splatoon at 3.1, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe at 6.75, and of course the outlier, Zelda Breath of the Wild at 13.6 gigabytes. And that makes me wonder, will we ever see another title as large as Breath of the Wild? Obviously that massive world led to a massive file size. Will Mario Odyssey have somewhere in between Rayman at 2.9 and Zelda at 13.6? Or will these Nintendo games going forward that aren't truly open world be more in the 2, 3, 4 range? It's interesting that Mario Kart 8 Deluxe was at 6.75, Splatoon 2, a brand new game that by just looking at it has more modes and more things going on, 3.1. So I don't really think too much of the file size in terms of the eventual quality or the eventual size or scope of the game. You have Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle coming in at 2.3 later this month, and we'll have to see where things like Fire Emblem Warriors and maybe even more interestingly, Xenoblade Chronicles 2 clock in when they release later this fall. But in the meantime, let us know what you think about this. And it's really cool because I purchased a 128 gig card before the Switch release, thinking that I would use that up quickly as I wanted to get a lot of digital titles, a lot of indie games, and have a lot of things just permanently on the system for that ultimate portability. But it's turned out that the onboard memory is pretty sizable, and I'm nowhere near filling up that 128, which is great. So we're not going to be swapping and switching a lot of memory cards. It seems like they're able to keep these things under control and allow for that digital future that some people have wanted for a long time. So let us know your take in the comments down below. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. Hope you're having a great day. Until next time, for myself and the rest of the Switch Force crew, Switch Force out.